Hi, I'm Aoibheann from the Belfast WIMPS Crew and I'm here at Stormont today to interview Health Minister Edwin Poots on youth suicide rates in Northern Ireland.
What is your opinion on youth suicide and suicide prevention in Northern Ireland?
Well, suicide is something that's high on our agenda. There are far too many people who are taking their own lives, some 313 in Northern Ireland in the last year. And very many of those people are young people. In fact, the highest area of prevalence is amongst young men. So we need to be working very hard on suicide prevention, and there is quite a lot of money being spent on suicide prevention and quite a lot of work going on, but we need to ensure that that is as effective as it can be.
What do you think should be done to tackle the issue of suicide prevention?
It's about providing the adequate care and cover for people who have depression, mental health issues and suicidal tendencies. So obviously we have organisations like Lifeline that we're giving around £3.5 million to, and they've got a 24-hour helpline, and we'd encourage people who have suicidal tendencies to call. Within our hospitals we've got a card before you leave, so anyone who has suicidal tendencies and attend a hospital casualty unit, for example, if they leave a card, within the 24 hours they will have people who have expertise to talk to them. People do need to realise that there is help, there's assistance out there. Young people in particular need to realise that it is a very final thing. It is something which is almost certainly the worst possible option for them.
What impact do you feel that economic downturn would have on the number of suicides?
Well, obviously youth unemployment's a big thing, and around one in four of young people are now long-term unemployed, and that's an unsatisfactory situation. So the work that the other departments do in terms of bringing job creation to Northern Ireland is essential, and in fact for every time the unemployment goes up by 1%, there's a correlation with suicide, where our suicide figures goes up by 0.8%. So, you know, the more we can do to attract investment to Northern Ireland and create jobs, again, where people can have a quality of life, then the better.
Do you think your department have the will to lead other departments in overcoming this issue?
Well, I've already spoken to other ministers about having more connectivity in government and working in a more collaborative way than was the case heretofore. And ultimately, you know, education is a key role to play. A lot of young people in the schools, and it's important that teachers are able to identify at an early point. Kids are becoming more and more isolated and, you know, withdrawn, and identify the symptoms at an early point where someone is becoming depressed or feeling that life isn't worth living. So there are certainly other departments that we will be working closely with in order to significantly reduce the numbers of people who are taking their own lives.
We obviously know that there's going to be cuts in a lot of the budget, but how do you plan on keeping suicide at the top of the agenda?
Well, the mental health budget is already a budget which I feel has not been receiving enough money for a number of years, so it's not a service that I'm looking to cut in any shape or form. I would want to enhance that budget, and therefore if we carry out rationalisation within the health service, as I believe we must, it is important that if there are savings accrued, that mental health gets some priority in actually receiving funding from that source.